All good, thanks. How are you? No, don't worry. I'm fine. I mean, look at me. Do I look stressed? Well, it doesn't matter how I look, because I'm not stressed, I mean. As I told you last week, I'm doing so much better now that I'm in, lockdown. Now I don't have to interact with people from school anymore, and now the exam pressure's off. Honestly, nothing's happened. I promise I'm fine. Well, aside from one thing, but honestly, it's no biggie. My anxiety levels are still under control. Nothing worth bothering you about. I'm sure you don't want to hear about my unnecessary problems, even though that is your day job. I'm sorry for saying that. I'm fine. I'm totally fine. Well, like I said before, not going into school has definitely helped me be less stressed. I mean, staying at home all day is what I wanted to do anyway before this whole thing started. Other stuff's helped too, though. Really gotten into cooking, which I find surprisingly therapeutic. And even if I do, get a bit down in the dumps, I've been using Headspace to do some meditation, which is honestly like taking a verbal warm bath. So yeah, I think that's why I'm less stressed. Well, I don't need to meditate that much, like once a week, something like that. Yeah, there's a couple reasons why I've been using Headspace. We keep on getting these promotional leaflets shoved through our letterbox, trying to get us to buy pets from some dodgy store, get kitchens installed from a dubious building society, which really annoys mum, because she's all like, "Who wants to buy kitchens at a time like this?" And when mum gets upset, it upsets me a bit. Well, a lot. I think that's the most major thing, to be honest. But yeah, anyways, I'm fine.
Marilyn! Marilyn!
Okay, so it might have been a more stressful day than I've been letting on. But would you mind if I talk to you about it? What happened? I need to talk about it with someone, but I do still think that this should be our last session. What's happened over the last 24 hours was a one-off. I don't need therapy anymore. So anyway, my whole disaster for 24 hours started when June, our neighbor, well, she's in her 80s, asked mum if I could walk her pug. Well, I think it's a pug. It might be a bulldog, or it might be a crossbreed. I'm not sure. It's actually got such a nice name. The dog, I mean. But June's an awful name. Why would anyone want to be called after a month? Anyways, I digress. Her dog's name is Marilyn. Don't you love that? I think June probably called her that because that dog is like a movie star to her. She bought it after her husband died, and she entrusted me to walk it, leaving it outside her house so we wouldn't be breaking any social distancing guidelines. We went to the park, and I let her off the leash, to give the dog a bit of freedom, and I lost it. I lost her movie star dog. So I hurriedly rushed home, calling June and asking if I could look after her dog overnight, to buy myself some time. And I tried to think of what to do. I couldn't, I can't tell June. That dog means literally everything to her. The only option was and still is to get back Marilyn. So I made a lost dog poster, not knowing what else to do. I wrote down my address and I tried drawing a picture of Marilyn, which turned out as good as my year-end art project. So I gave up on the poster. I tried to look up solutions online, but all pet stores were closed because of the whole lockdown shebang, which is when I remember those rubbish leaflets my mum keeps being sent in the post. So I ran outside to the bins and began methodically looking for the leaflets, and I quickly found the one I was looking for. The one for pet stores. Hello? Oh, hi. How are you? So I was wondering if I could buy a bulldog, no pug. No, a brown furry thing that looks like some sort of bulldog pug mix. Could you deliver it by tomorrow? You could, fantastic. I'll pay your delivery driver on the door, right? That's what it says on the leaflet. No, I'm not picky, as long as you can deliver it by tomorrow. Coolio. Bye. And then the package arrived. I mean, in whose twisted world does a rabbit look anything like a bull pug thing named Marilyn? In whose bloody world? So, this is the rabbit. And no, before you ask, I didn't just get a rabbit because my name is Warren. I don't know what to do. What is June gonna think of me? What do you mean a minor setback? I feel like in only one day, in 24 hours, so much of the anxiety I've worked so hard to get rid of has just come flooding back, and I know I shouldn't hate myself for just this one thing, but I do. And I don't know how to change that. And I know I'll feel better once I've sorted this whole thing out. And I know storms pass, and I know I'll be supported through my setbacks like the one I've had today. And I don't know what I have to do. I have to talk to her, don't I? Okay. I can do this. Thank you. Hello? Yeah, June. Hi. How are you? Well, I'll drop your dog off in an hour, if that's okay. Yeah, great, okay. Alright, thank you. Bye. Jack.